Hi, I'm Mike.
I'm Don.
And this is the International Space Station Science Garage.
We have...
I'm just along for the ride here. Go ahead, what do we got?
We have an example of an aeroponic...
Expected me to know that.
An aeroponic growth chamber.
Holy cow.
And that's what we have here.
That's what that thing is.
Yeah, it's an aeroponic growth chamber.
Okay, so this isn't like anything you'd want to drink.
No, you don't want to drink it.
But
it's a means of growing plants.
Yeah.
And this is what NASA uses on orbit is aeroponics. And think of hydroponics. That's where you grow plants without any dirt, right?
Hydro meaning water.
Right. Well, aeroponics is one stage removed from hydroponics.
You grow plants with nothing.
You grow plants with air saturated with water around their roots, mm-hmm. and you feed them all the nutrients they need, and then the plants grow outside of the root chamber like they normally do.
So how does this differ from hydroponics?
You don't have
water involved.
Well, there's less water involved.
Less water.
With a hydroponics, you might have like several gallons of water with mm-hmm. the roots stuck into the water. Mm-hmm. With aeroponics, you have maybe only a few ounces of water that's mm-hmm. atomized and circulated around a mm-hmm. chamber where the roots are just hanging in the air.
Whoa, that sounds like science fiction.
And that is what you'd want to do in a weightless environment, so you wouldn't have to deal with how do you handle large quantities of liquid being pumped around the roots.
And liquid's valuable too.
You don't
worry about as much.
So aeroponics is the way to go if you're going to be in a weightless environment where water is a precious commodity.
Okay, so in both cases you're kind of without dirt. Right.
You're without
dirt.
Dirt
is a good thing for plants.
Is a good thing for plants, but fortunately, we can figure out what most of the nutrients are that plants need from the dirt, and we can give them to the plants by dissolving them in the water that's either in hydroponics or the smaller quantities of water that are in the aeroponics. And so you could still get plants to thrive and be healthy.
This sounds like a big scientific area here.
It is a big scientific
area. The farmers of our world
dirt's cheap, and so you know
it's not a big deal. This is more of a
scientific way of growing things when you don't have a lot of dirt.
Okay, so let's take examples of places that need food that don't have a lot of dirt, like in the desert somewhere.
Yeah, or Antarctica.
Antarctica.
Or maybe mobile applications, like if you're on some kind of vessel and you want to grow some mm-hmm. garden greens to spice up your food or something mm-hmm. like that. Spacecraft. Colonization, you're going away from planet Earth, you're probably going to be using either hydroponics or aeroponics to grow your plants.
Okay, so it's driven by a space need, at least with
NASA has grabbed it and is running with it for space.
But it has applications to all kinds of
It
places.
Does. And we are this doing this on space station right now mm-hmm. using aeroponic gardening techniques mm-hmm. to raise plants in the orbital environment on space station.
Okay. So what do we got? Explain this to me. Now, this is a very interesting looking device you have here.
Yeah. And this is really set up in sprouter mode. So this one is not actually running in an aeroponic mode right now because mm-hmm. there's a pretty big bucket of water down here and we're just getting the seeds to sprout. But what I have here is this plant called Arabidopsis.
That's his name, or is that what it is?
It's both.
Okay.
Arabidopsis.
Is that what it says here? Is that what you have written here?
Yeah.
You can't see it, but there's some, like...
Yeah, Arabidopsis.
Writing.
And you have the date
it's
when you started.
It's a dinosaur or something.
Arabidopsis?
Yeah.
You say like that...
Arabidopsis.
Arabidopsis.
Arabidopsis versus Velociraptor.
It's genetically very simple, mm-hmm. and scientists have gravitated towards Arabidopsis as a model plant that they're studying its genome with. And they can torque with this plant, and they can make different variants on it to see what happens. So it's a model plant used by scientists to study different genome effects.
So if for growing more stuff, For learning how plants work.
It's just like we do experiments on mice that are related towards human beings.
Yeah.
And so why do we do the experiment?
This is a mouse.
Yeah, so this is a plant equivalent of a mouse. I wanted to see, could you have a potted plant in a corner?
And the answer was?
It's difficult to do, but you can.
You can.
Yes.
But it's important because you got to grow. Isn't there like regular experiments on space station?
Oh, there are. There are regular experiments that have formalized pieces of hardware with terrariums and all of that stuff.
Right.
And they use aeroponics to grow these seeds, and that's part of a big principal investigator experiment.
But you didn't do it that way.
I flew with seeds, and then I tried to figure out how to do this once I got on orbit.
But your plants were pretty big. You told me.
I had a sunflower. I was able to grow a sunflower that was a meter and a half long.
From a seed.
Yeah, and it bloomed and it made seeds.
All right, so I'm guessing these experiments from these principal investigators didn't have anything really big growing.
Well, maybe they have a growth chamber about like that, or
right,
maybe the growth chamber's like this.
But yours was out in the open.
Mine was out in the open.
So you had like a garden going on.
Well, I don't know what I call it, a garden, but I had a few plants.
I would call it a garden. So you had like a park. So the space zucchini, what were we saying? You grew your own stuff.
Yeah, I wanted to see whether you could have, without a lot of equipment that took power and computer control and all that, just the equivalent of a potted plant in the corner in space station.
Right.
And so I brought a few seeds. I brought zucchini, broccoli, and sunflower. I figured those would be good things to try, and experiment a number of different concepts of trying to grow these aeroponically, passive aeroponics, so it didn't have pumps and motors and stuff like that moving around, just with plastic bags passively sitting there in front of light on station, using nutrients composted from food. So I started a little compost pile, and I was able to have space zucchini.
In which you didn't eat this, of course.
No. Because he became like a crew member. Now, sunflower normally grows really straight stalks, right?
Yeah, gigantic, some of them.
And so I had this sunflower, a meter and a half tall.
That's big.
And the stalk was like that thick. The stalk was maybe 3 millimeters thick. So it didn't put any energy into making the stalk because it didn't need to.
So the stalk, how big is a stalk on the, they're beefy.
A sunflower that'd be a meter and a half tall would probably have a stalk maybe 6, 7, 8 millimeters in diameter.
This is less than half.
Yes, and so the sunflower is kind of like human beings in that they're inherently lazy, and if they don't have to put the energy into making a stalk to stand up, they don't.
So that stalk would not work.
It would not work on Earth.
Fall over.
Yeah, and another thing, sunflower stalks are straight.
Yeah.
This stalk was just all curvy.
That's where we'd naturally go. So what's the idea? So you have these little things that you really can't get anything you can eat.
Right.
You've had this stuff growing in the hallway.
Yeah.
In space there, in the middle of a module, and you could eat that stuff.
You could.
So what would you think if you're going on a trip to Mars, let's say, and you need to grow some vegetables or fruit or what, I guess, I don't know, whatever you want to grow, what do you think the ideal?
Well, you would want to have a genuine design engineered growth chamber based off of aeroponics, and you would want to bring...
You have a farm, basically.
Yeah, you'd have a small farm.
A farm module.
That's right, a farm module. Mm-hmm. I like that concept.
All right, so that's what you'd set it up right so the stuff has enough room to grow.
Enough room to grow with adequate lighting, and you'd provide the nutrients, and you do it in an aeroponic manner, and you could grow a significant amount of pleasantries to add to your normal food.